Good afternoon. We're looking at some conditions that are looking a lot brighter in the Southern Valley. We earlier just looked at Grand Forks is gray. We have some flakes in that area. In Fargo, on our First Alert SkyCam network, we're looking off to the west, and you can see that along I-94, they've got some sunshine shining down on the vehicles there. And we're right on the edge of that cloud deck in the Fargo-Moorhead area here this afternoon. So it really depends on where you are, what you're dealing with. And we're all having to put up with the cold. At least we're in the teens and 20s throughout the valley. It's 24 in Fargo and 22 in Grand Forks. The cold spot only 14 at the noon hour in Langdon. So again, a chilly day here today. And when we factor in the winds, which are a little brisk here, we've got wind speeds into the teens and 20s out of the west or northwest. When we factor those in, we've got some wind chills to still focus on. In fact, the wind chill in Langdon is 2 below right now. It's 1 in Devil's Lake and a wind chill of 7 over in Fauston and Roseau as well. So again, an afternoon to bundle up, whether you're seeing clouds or sun or even some flakes. And you can see the radar detecting the snowflakes and the flurries underneath some of those clouds closer to the radar site. We're probably dealing with some flurries north and east as well. And then over by Jamestown and southern end of the valley, you can see where the clouds have cleared out a little bit more and where we're really getting to enjoy that sunshine. Just zooming in on this area where we're seeing the flaky activity, you can see it's more over toward Crookston at the moment, Norman County down toward Ada, and again, Fargo right on the edge of this. And we saw some flakes in Fargo not too long ago. There's morning. So here's a look at our hour-by-hour planner. We started in the teens and 20s, and watch as we head into the afternoon. We stay in the teens and 20. We'll be around 3 o'clock, 3, 4 o'clock is typically when we see our warmest temperatures of the day, and we'll be right basically where we are now, maybe a couple of degrees warmer at this point in time, still with that breeze and still with some areas dealing with some light snow or some flurries going on. That should gradually end as we head into tonight. The wind will also ease up into the overnight hours. You can see by midnight, we're mainly clearing out and the wind has eased and it's starting to take a southerly turn. The sooner that happens, the better for keeping those temperatures up or even recovering after initially dipping tonight. We need that south wind to keep that air a little bit warm or at least from bottoming out too much. But tomorrow will likely start off into the teens. There may be a couple of places that have lows in the single digits for your Friday morning. Heading into the rest of the day on Friday, expect sunshine. There will be a little bit of wind though out of the south. It's going to start gusting into the 20s and 30s into the afternoon. But temperatures will be climbing as we head further into the afternoon. Expect to see some numbers that are into the mid 30s for some of us up north. In the Southern Valley, we could end up around 40 degrees or so in Fargo and in southeastern North Dakota. So this will be a nice little recovery from this cool down that we've got going on here today. And the rest of your Friday looks pretty quiet too. So looking good heading into the weekend as far as not having to deal with any weather makers. However, there's another one coming in. This one, Saturday night and into Sunday, we have the potential for some scattered light precipitation. It might be a little bit of a mix because of the warmer air, but overnight with temperatures below freezing, if we do get enough, there could be some slick spots to start off on Sunday. Saturday will be milder. We'll be into the 40s. Sunday kind of cooling things down in the wake of this front, and we'll end up with temperatures next week, more of the same, 30s and 40s. So that warm up that we had recently, that's done. Now we're really heading into that late fall and early cold season timeframe here, and we're feeling it now in the valley.
You know, it's cold whenever the highest temperatures are in the 40s, and this is something I'm still getting used to myself, but bring a jacket like you always tell me to do, and we should be all right. Thanks again.